Well, the World and Olympic champions, number one seeds, having arrived here in Dubai. They've won all of their matches in two straight games. They really have been in terrific form. Six titles this year, but for their opponents, they didn't even think they were going to get the trip to Dubai. Late replacements, and haven't they grasped the opportunity to perform here at the Super Series Finals? The number one seeds, Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei. This their fifth consecutive final here at the Super Series Finals, having won the 2010 edition and the 2011 edition. In 2012 and 2013, they were beaten on both occasions by Nielsen and Christina Pedersen. The Danish pair were beaten by the youngsters, who will be coming onto court in just a moment. Liu Cheng and Bao Yixin. And this all-Chinese affair, well, it's only the second time we've had an all-Chinese affair in the mixed doubles final here at the Super Series Finals. The first time was in 2011 in Luzhou in China.
Shuttle or racket?
So,
shuttle? Shuttle?
Bow
service. Service? Bow service?
Bow is serving.
Okay.
So the World and Olympic champions, Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei. Nine Super Series tournaments this year for the world number ones. Five finals, winning four of them prior to this event. So this is their eighth final in 12 tournaments. And for Zhao Yunlei, this is her seventh final at Super Series Finals. Because, of course, she was in the women's doubles final earlier today, where she and partner Tian Qing lost to the Japanese pair of Matsutomo and Takahashi. Well, as I was saying, they have won all of their matches in two straight games. The semi-final was a repeat of the Thursday group match against Mr. and Mrs. Adcock. And that, in fact, was the longest match that they've had so far, 39 minutes. That is extraordinary, isn't it? So they have been in wonderful form. Of course, Gabby Adcock wasn't terribly well yesterday, couldn't give her best. But as far as the former world junior champions, won the gold medal at the World Junior Championships in Guadalajara in Mexico 4 years ago. They were in stunning form last night when they beat the two-time defending champions and three-time winners, Joachim Fischer-Nielsen and Christina Pedersen. Number eight in the world ranking at the moment. And their semi-final was only 38 minutes. And look at the scoreline, 21-13, 21-12. So I think it is very fitting that we've got two pairs contesting the mixed doubles final who have come through the whole competition, the group stages, which are round robin, everybody plays everybody else, and of course the semi-final knockout stage, and neither pair has been beaten so far. So it's always nice, Morten, when we have a final with players who have come through unscathed.
Couldn't agree with you more. I must admit I was very impressed. I did not see the match yesterday because it was after our time on TV. But when the two youngsters here in the picture beat the Danes, Fischer and Pedersen, I was very impressed with the scores.
Yeah.
I must admit that.
Jakob Sindberg, our umpire from Denmark. Rohana da Silva of Sri Lanka, our service judge.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Bao Yixin, Liu Cheng, China. And on my left, Xiao Yunlai, Sangman, China. Bao Yixin to serve to Sangman. Love all. Play.
So the younger pair, Liu Cheng, 22, as indeed is Bao Yixin, against the world and Olympic champions Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei. Now this is the fifth meeting between these two pairs. On the previous four occasions, not only have the world and Olympic champions won on all four occasions, but they haven't dropped a game. And the last time they played against each other, I think, Morton, you and I watched that. That was in the quarterfinal of the recent Hong Kong Open. 21-16, 21-9. It was very, very convincing in this that second game. But it's always funny, I think, sometimes when players or pairs suddenly get a chance to play in an event, because, of course, unfortunately, the pair that ended the year number one on the Destination Dubai list, Zhu Chen and Ma Jin, couldn't make it to Dubai, injury problems. And so, therefore, these youngsters in the yellow kit got the call up because they were the number eight ranked pair. But, of course, you're only allowed two pairs per nation. So they weren't originally invited.
Yes.
And so when a Chinese pair dropped out, they then did get the invitation. And I sort of thought, well, I wonder if they're properly prepared. They probably thought their year was over. How wrong I was.
You know, I can't help replying like this. In 1992, Denmark was asked to play the European Championship.
Don't you
football.
Dare. Don't
football.
You dare.
And they went on to win it. And that's exactly the same situation.
It is, you rascal. Yes, sore point between Morton and myself.
Yep.
Football.
Yep. Why not?
Oh. 3-2.
Oh, that's nice. That is nice from Bao Yixin.
3-0. Shall we see?
Goodness, what happened there?
Too ambitious, I think.
Yeah.
Couldn't make her up her mind.
Strings are gone in the racket of Liu Cheng. Not an awful lot he could do about that. Yeah, did you see that? He looked at his racket before he played the shot. He knew the strings had gone. Well, there's Zhang Jun, twice Olympic mixed doubles champion. He's sitting in the crowd, happily watching his two pairs here. And he'll be interested to see how they do. And I can't help but think, Morten, you and I were discussing the other day about the potential and the merits of Bao Yixin and how she could potentially become one of the great players. That's a delightful shot from her partner, Liu Cheng. And I can't help but think, you know, we're a little under 2 years away from the Olympic Games in Rio. I wonder who will be the more successful mixed doubles player come 2 years' time between the two women on court at the moment.
Yeah, that's a good question.
Yeah.
That's a very good question. I think that would be Bao Yixin.
Yeah. I wouldn't be surprised either. This is possibly a first, not changing of the guard, because we don't know the result, but I think this is...
This is the first sign.
Yeah.
Margin has been there for a while, but has not really been able to sort of overtake that position. It's been...
No.
It's been very close, but not really overtaking it.
Service over.
But the interesting part is that Xiang Nan is not that old.
No, he's only 24.
And I'm sitting here thinking, why not partner those two?
That had occurred to me too. Zhao Yunlei is 28 years of age.
Oh. 8-5.
It'd be wrong for us, you know, we can't, I don't like to ever write a player off, but, you know, there were signs in that women's doubles final, you were pointing out frailties in Zhao Yunlei.
Yeah,
in the women's doubles.
In the women's doubles. Obviously, that will only come into play later on in mixed doubles.
Yeah.
But there is no doubt that in terms of movement on court, inverted commas, she's struggling a little bit. Struggling is a hard word to use.
Yeah.
Nine.
But we are talking about the best of the best. And it's tiny little detailed differences that make the difference.
Yes.
Service over. 7-9.
Just to finish that little discussion, I think that somehow Zhao Yunlei is a little bit more injury prone than many other players are. So that's also one of the things I'm sort of looking at. So I've seen her been struggling, and on a few occasions she had to withdraw from tournaments and so on because of injuries. So, and she keeps playing two events as well, so it's a very hard task to do.
Well, that's an interesting point in itself. I wonder if come Rio Olympic Games that she will still be playing two events.
11-7 interval.
Well, it's a 4-point advantage for Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei. It's mid-game interval. And of course, there's no coaching staff because two Chinese pairs playing against each other.
But it makes no difference to you and me. We still don't understand it.
No. Doesn't seem to be a lot of discussion anyway.
11, 7, play.
That's where she's so good, isn't it?
That was awesome. Fantastic. Very good interception here.
It's five straight points. Well, that was getting out too.
Defense.
September 8-14.
There were some nice interceptions in that rally from Bowie Sint. Good judgment on the back nine there. Olympic champions talking to the umpire about that?
Who to receive, I think.
Okay.
Liu Cheng is really a little bit under pressure here. He's got to start producing some of his wonderful smashes and attacking play, because otherwise the much more experienced player from China will run away with it.
Yeah, it's found the line.
Seven's over.
Yeah, it's occurred to me, Morton, the fact that these two pairs 16. Obviously trained together in the National Training Centre. They've played against each other four times in international competition, and the younger pair have never won even a game, and so psychologically there might be a bit of a block as well, because when we watched Liu Cheng earlier in the week, we were astounded by how hard he was hitting it. In fact, you said he's probably smashing harder than any player.
Yeah, he's definitely up there in the top 5, 10, whatever,
yeah,
in the world in terms of power, and but he's hardly getting a chance here, and that's what they have to start doing. They've got to get it, get the initiative, get the attack. So exactly, that's it.
10-17
around the back, it all count. Well, Xiao Yunlei getting caught at the back of the court there.
She did in the deep forehand corner. Here, this is it. She's actually, that's a decent drive. But look at that. She had the opportunity to move forward, but she stopped. Just a little sign of what we just discussed earlier.
Yeah. That's a super turn of serve.
18-11.
One of the reasons why Xiang Nan and Xiao Yunlei is 19-11 up is also the fact that Xiao Yunlei is really controlling the net. She is making it very easy for her partner.
The drop shot and immediately move forward to allow Zhang Nan to go to the back of the court, and as soon as he got involved he made the error.
12, yeah.
This one here, in she goes. Yeah. That was the right thing to do though, presumably.
It was textbook.
Yeah. Nice return and a nice way to bring up game point opportunities.
13. Yeah, that's a very good return.
Oh, that was nice. Well worked by the youngsters. No serve is just short. 21-15 the opening game. 21-15 in 20 minutes in favour of the world and Olympic champions.
Considering the start, I think that was actually a decent score.
Yeah.
For the youngsters, they got all the way to 15.
Yeah.
At a certain stage, I thought it would be a lot less than that.
Yeah, because they were 16-9 down, 16-8 down actually. Mm. Interesting. Who was the boss in that partnership?
Isn't it always the woman?
Come on.
No, that was bad. Do apologise.
You're all right.
So. But I think she's right. I think what she's trying, you don't see it on the screen here. But I think she's right in what she's gesturing on the court while we're watching.
Mm.
Is that we have to get the attack.
Yeah.
She's sort of indicating lift is no good, we have to go for it.
Yeah.
Twenty seconds. Second game, love all, play. Service over, one, love.
Clearly in. It is quite remarkable, though, Morton, in the fact that Zhang Nang and Zhao Yunlei, this is only their fifth full year together. They did actually play one tournament in 2009, the China Open. But it was really 2010 they really started their partnership. Five Super Series finals appearances, five finals.
Yeah.
Talk about consistency.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
It's remarkable, isn't it?
Three, one.
Unbelievable.
How did he get that one back?
What a rally. Oh, it's landed in. She deliberately left it. Bowie Sin thought it was going to go long.
But chances were good.
Two,
just stopped
three.
Short of the baseline there.
Well, the defence of Liu
look
Cheng.
That
look
one.
At that one.
That one was good.
Unbelievable.
Play. Four, Service over. Four. Ball.
Good play from
Charlie. 5-4. Service over. 5-5.
Instinctive shot.
Yeah, that was a good block.
No! Service over.
Morton, I want your opinion about Jiang Nan. And the fact that this year, instead of just concentrating wholeheartedly on the mixed doubles discipline, he's been playing men's doubles.
And done really well.
With Fu Haifeng.
On occasions.
They won the Denmark Open, didn't they?
They did.
Do you think it's good for him to be playing two events? Or do you think, come the Olympic qualifying period, Jiang Nan will just be playing the one discipline?
I think he will just be playing the one.
But has the men's doubles experience helped in his mixed doubles development?
I think it will always help. But somehow, I know they, him and Fu Haifeng did really well and won the Denmark Open. And then the following week in the French Open, they crashed out quite early, as far as I remember. And somehow, because China is so good, I think if you're in a discipline, you've got to make a difference, or you have to be on your way up. And somehow, I don't see the partnership between Fu Haifeng and Jiang Nan being a partnership they really, really want to push. Somehow, I don't know, but it's just a feeling.
So, do you think that, obviously, the reigning Olympic champions, Cai Yun and Fu Haifeng, have both been put with younger partners. And do you think that they're using the experience of the former world champions and current Olympic champions to bring on younger players? So it's all thought process for maybe 2 years' time, because in 2 years' time, is Xiao Yun Lei still going to be playing? She's 28 now, at the age of 30, will she still be playing the World Tour? Do they want, at the age of 26 in 2 years' time, Jiang Nan playing maybe men's doubles?
That could be an option.
Yeah.
That could be an option. But at the moment, also as we've seen Hong Wei and Chai Biao develop, they have a lot of options, China. And I somehow think that they will stick to their guns with this mixed doubles, which is doing so well.
A good backhand flat over the net from Jiang Nan. Look at that, whipped it cross court.
That's where I think Bao Yixin possibly have to move back a little bit to cover that one.
Mm.
I know she, it's a very difficult situation for her because she's got to close down the net, but at the same time she's got to cover that cross one. And it's not easy. I totally accept that. But it was all almost too simple, and if you saw the replays, she was kind of getting too close to the net and ducking a little bit.
Yeah. Oh, yes. Fast and furious rally. And it is the number one seed to have the 1 point advantage here at the mid-game interval of the second game. Wasn't the best of serves, was it?
I've got out of trouble.
12, 10.
At least he saved it himself. Nothing but a perfect shot would have been good enough. It was a very, very tight shot by Bao Yixin. Have to be careful here because this is four straight points for the World and Olympic champions. That's that. Just that. So that's
15,
five.
10.
And at 15-10.
Number one, 16-10.
intensity or even up the intensity at these crucial moments. Quick run of points makes a huge impact and it's a whole different complexion on the match.
17
Seven straight points. Didn't this happen in the second game of the women's singles?
Yes, I'm thinking. Yes, I think it did. Eight in a row.
Just 3 points away from a third Super Series finals title.
Service over. 11-18.
Don't you think it's a little bit too little too late here?
Yeah. But I'm liking the fact that the youngsters are still in their fighting. They haven't capitulated. They're still wanting to do well, wanting to win points. Nice.
Service over.
Yeah, I think this is just another 12. Example of the fact that I honestly don't think that Liu Cheng has been able to follow pace in this match.
No.
I think he has somehow been the weakest link.
Smash down the centre of the court, and that brings up eight match point opportunities. First time of asking, 21-15, 21-12. In just under 40 minutes of play. So a third Super Series finals title for Zhang Nang and Zhao Yunlei.
And no one took them over 40 minutes.
No. That's incredible, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, she was disappointed with the women's doubles, Zhao Yunlei. But the BWF Female Player of the Year, Zhao Yunlei, has ended the year in fine style in this mixed doubles. Well, I'm sure we're going to see an awful lot more of Bao Yi Xin on the mixed doubles court. She's already been world number one in the women's doubles. So we're going to have a chance to hear from the winners who are courtside right now.
Congratulations on being named the BWF Player of the Year this week, Zhao Yunlei. And now you're the BWF Destination Dubai World Super Series Mixed Doubles Champion. How does that feel?
就是这一次取得了这个迪拜世界羽毛球公开赛最后这个最佳称号，女单最佳称号，同时呢，今天刚才你又获得了这个混双的冠军，那么你的感受是什么呀？你想说点什么？我觉得还有很多不足的地方吧，然后回去训练，希望下一次能表现更好。
There's still a lot to do to improve myself, so I hope that next time I can do better.
Will you be coming back to defend your title here in Dubai next year? It's a great city to host these finals, isn't it?
就是你明年回来以后卫冕你的冠军的时候，你认为这个迪拜是不是一个非常好的城市，继续就是发挥你？
我觉得迪拜是一个非常好的城市吧，希望下一次来的时候，我的发挥能像这个城市一样越来越好。
Yeah, Dubai is a wonderful city. I hope that next time when I come back to defend my title, I will do as good as Dubai, as such a beautiful, you know, nice country, nice city. Yep.
And Zhang Nan, just tell us about your Dubai experience.
你能谈谈你的迪拜这个经历吗？
非常开心，第一次在迪拜举行总决赛，我们就可以获得冠军，所以我希望明年再来的时候可以为所有的球迷奉献更精彩的比赛，谢谢。
It's my first time to have ever come to Dubai to play the final, and I got the championship, you know, so I hope next year when I come here, I can bring in more excitement and a beautiful performance to the spectators and friends here.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei.
Well, well said by both of them, Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei. A 51st career title for Zhao Yunlei. A 31st for Zhang Nan. 82 career titles between them. Yeah, throws a towel to the fans.
WF Destination Dubai World Super Series Finals 2014 and the Mixed Doubles.
presentation party make their way to centre stage.
The medals, checks and trophies will be presented by Abdul Mushin Al-Dosari, Assistant Secretary General of the General Authority of Youth and Sports Welfare at the Dubai Sports Council, Manoj Poduval, Agency Director, Golf MetLife, and Peter Tsasala, Chair of the BWF Events Committee. The runners-up in the BWF Destination Dubai World Super Series Finals 2014 mixed doubles from China, Liu Cheng and Bao Yixin.
Liu Cheng and Bao Yixin. Their second Super Series tournament final. They were beaten finalists in Hong Kong last year. Got the late call up to come to Dubai, and my goodness, they've made the most of their opportunities all the way through to the final.
The winners of the BWF Destination Dubai World Super Series Finals 2014 mixed doubles from China, Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei.
For a third time, Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei win the Super Series Finals title. A seventh title of the year.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the BWF Destination Dubai World Super Series Mixed Doubles 2014 from China, Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei.
They are quite clearly the best player pair in world badminton in the mixed doubles discipline. Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei. Whoops, steady on. So yet another title for Zhang Nang and Zhao Yunlei. A 28th career title for them as a pair. Fabulous week it's been here in Dubai at the Super Series finals, and what a great finals day. One title to Korea, two to China, and a first ever title for Japan, and indeed a first ever title for Chinese Taipei. Well, of course, that concludes things from Dubai for this year. The Super Series finals will be back for the next 3 years, but in the meantime, from all of us here, until the next time, take care. Bye-bye.